Good morning, my dear students, and also welcome to electronics online classes. And in the last class, you have completed about the operational amplifier, and also completed some problems on that operational amplifier. And as I said already, today we'll start the new topic that is very interesting and also very important topic, but it is a very small topic, and that carries only 7 marks in your exam. And in that 7 marks, you will ask one question on problem for 5 marks, and another 2 mark question, 1 2 mark question. The maximum having 7 marks for that oscillator topic. And today we will go for the lecture number one. It's not the lecture number one. And the name of the topic is about oscillators. Look here, as you already completed the 5 topics, it may be the field level transistor, or maybe your transistor biasing, or maybe your transistor amplifiers. And also you have completed about that feedback amplifiers, and finally you have completed the last class about the operational amplifier. And today onwards you start the new topic, the chapter number 6. You are starting the chapter number 6 according to your NCERT syllabus for second UC electronics, and the name of the topic is about oscillators. And as usual, first you go for the in this today's class, you go for the introduction to the oscillators and applications and types of oscillators, and also we go for the principle of oscillators. Here, first you go for the introduction to the oscillators, and maybe in the time of amplifiers, as I said, one thing important that is so surprising in electronics, that is not possible in general. What is that surprising thing? The surprising thing is that in electronics, if we give very small things, but they will give the very large things. That is nothing but amplifiers. Because in amplifier, you are applying very, very low input signal, but you will get the very high output signal or very large output signal as output. That is nothing but amplifiers. In simple way amplifier, you are applying very, very small things, but you will get at the output very, very more things. That is in general nothing but your amplifiers. And because I said, it's not possible in general, because if you deposit some amount in bank, they are not giving more than 10 times or 20 times, or they are not giving more than 100 times. But that is only possible in electronics. In the same way, already you studied in detail about amplifiers. In the same way, another important thing that also happens in electronics, without giving anything, there is something. That is nothing but your oscillator. Once again, write it here. If you have any confusion, means in general meaning of oscillator. In general meaning of oscillator, without giving anything, without giving anything, that will give you something. That also not possible in general. What is oscillator? I am saying in general meaning.
oscillator nothing but in oscillator without giving anything, but it will give something. That will give something. It will give something. It will give something. That is nothing but nothing but your oscillator. Right? It means actually in oscillator you are not applying any input. In oscillator you are not applying any input. Still you will get the output. That is nothing but the in general meaning of your oscillator. Right? And actually what is the actual definition of your oscillator? Actual definition of oscillator. The any circuit which will produce the AC signals or it will generate the AC signals, that is nothing but oscillator. Any circuit or any device that will produce or generate the AC signals, that is nothing but the oscillator. And this is simple way, another way of definition. The oscillator is a device, they will give you the output without applying any input. Once again, repeat, oscillator is a circuit or device. In oscillator, without giving any input, it will give the output. That is nothing but oscillator. Another way, in oscillator, the oscillator will convert the DC. They will convert DC signal into the AC signal. Maybe I said in three ways about the definition of oscillator. One simple definition, oscillator, it is a circuit or it is a device. They will generate, they will produce the AC signals or AC voltages. And another one is about in oscillator, it is a device or circuit. In oscillator, you are not giving any input, but still it will give the output. Without giving any input, it will give the output. That is also called as oscillator. And third definition, actually in oscillator, the oscillator will convert the DC signal into the AC signal. In oscillator, they will convert the DC signal into the AC signal. And sometimes the oscillator is also called as signal generator. It is also called as inverter. The oscillator is also called as signal generator or also called as inverters. And especially in your oscillators, very required oscillators. This is I said about the three way of definition of oscillators. Once again repeat, oscillator, it is a circuit or device. They will produce or they will give you the AC signals or they will generate the AC signals. They will produce the AC signals. That is in simple way of definition. And second definition, in oscillator, without giving any input, it will give the output. In oscillator, you are not applying any input, still you will get the output. That is the importance of your oscillator. And last one is about in oscillators, it is a circuit or device, it will convert the DC signal into AC signal, or it will convert the DC source. You can write about DC source. DC source into the AC source, or you can convert DC to the AC, or you can write in simple way about it will convert DC to AC. Convert DC to AC. That is nothing but your oscillators. And especially in every electronic device, we want the AC signals. Or in every electronic device, you are having the oscillator. In every electronic device that consists of a oscillator, because in electronic devices they require the AC signals.
and how to produce or how to generate a signal, that is by using your oscillators. In oscillators will generate these signals, because in electronics devices we want the AC signal or we want the oscillators. In every electronic device that consists of oscillators, and especially you consider your communication. In communication we want oscillators. And why we want in communication oscillators? To generate the carrier signal or to generate the master oscillator. And especially in your in communication, it may be the radio or it may be TV, it may be the transmitter section or maybe receiving section, may require the oscillators to generate the carrier signal or to generate the your by using your master oscillator. That will give the, it is also called, it is used as a local oscillator. In communication it will act as a local oscillator. And also in your computers it is used as a clock. In computers it is used as a clock. And also in your it is also useful in your radio communication or in your mobile communication or your satellite communication, or also it is in your radars. Nowadays the radars or in mobile communication or in satellite communication, we require the oscillators. Because why we require oscillators? Because especially we want low frequency signal, also we want some high frequency signal. And how to generate the how low frequency and high frequency signals? That is nothing but by using oscillators. We can generate the low frequency signal, also we can generate the high frequency signal by using your oscillators. And also by using oscillator you can generate the different waveforms. You can get the different waveforms. And this is about, in brief, about oscillators. And as I said, what are the main applications of your oscillators? The most important application, it is used in your communication. It may be radio communication, or it may be TV communication, or it may be your mobile communication or satellite communication or your radars. We require the AC signals, or we require very high frequency signal, very low frequency signal. And also, as I said to people, in your communication it is used in receiving section, also it is in the transmitting section. And also, as I said to people about in communication, about it is used as a local oscillator, it is used as a carrier, it is used as a carrier frequency. To generate the carrier frequency, we are using about the oscillators. And finally, about I said about in computer, it is used as a clock. And also in radar, in satellite communication, in mobile communication, we are using about the oscillators. This is about the applications of your oscillators. Now we'll go for another way of oscillator. Actually, as I said about already, basically your oscillator is a type of amplifier. Basically your oscillator is a type of amplifier. Or you can say, what is the difference about amplifier and oscillator? Amplifier and oscillator. What is the major difference about amplifier and oscillator? And as you know already, the amplifier will amplify the signal. But important thing in amplifier, they require the input signal. They require the input voltage. In amplifier, they require input voltage. And here, no input voltage, no input voltage. It means in amplifier we are not applying any input, but we are not getting any output. But in oscillator, without applying any input, still you get the output. That is the major difference about amplifier and oscillator. And also another difference, in your amplifier you are using negative feedback. You are using negative feedback. And in oscillator, I was in positive. I already studied in detail about feedback amplifiers.
using the force field. And finally, because as you know already, why you are using negative feedback in your amplifiers? Yes, to reduce the noise, to reduce the distortions, and we want stability in the gain. Also, we want more input impedance, less output impedance. That's why you prefer the negative feedback in your amplifiers. But as I said, in the time of feedback amplifiers, in oscillator we are using the positive feedback. In oscillator we are using the positive feedback. And because of negative feedback, what happens? The voltage gain will be reduces. But here the voltage gain. It will be in this. And why the voltage gain decreases? Because you are applying negative feedback. And we know already negative feedback nothing but the feedback signal and input signal are in the out of phase. Right? And here in positive feedback, the feedback signal and input signal are in the in phase. And they will increase the input voltage, they will decrease the input voltage. This is about in brief the difference of amplifier and oscillator. Another important thing, the oscillator is also type of amplifier, but important thing you are using positive feedback. Oscillator is also type of amplifier, but you are using the positive feedback. Because as we know already, the amplifier also convert DC to AC. The amplifier also convert DC to AC. But oscillator also convert DC to AC. But very small change here in amplifier, the amplifier will convert DC to AC, that require the input. But here in oscillator also they will convert DC to AC, but without applying any input. It means in your amplifier the output voltage or in your the amplifier output, it may be magnitude or maybe your frequency or maybe your waveform, that depends upon the input voltage. In amplifier, the amplifier output that depends the amplifier signal, the magnitude of the output signal or the frequency of the output signal or the waveform, that depends upon the input signal. But here in oscillator, the output signal, it depends itself. It means it does not depend upon the input signal. The output signal that depends upon itself, nothing but that depends only on the oscillator circuit. It means in general, in amplifier, we require the input voltage. The output depends upon the input voltage. But in oscillator, output does not depend upon the input. It depends itself, the oscillator only. That is about the major difference about your amplifier and oscillator. It means basically oscillator is also type of amplifier, but you are using the positive feedback. Once again, I repeat, oscillator, it is also type of amplifier, but you are using positive feedback. Because in amplifier, it will convert DC to AC. But in oscillator also we are converting DC to AC. But here they require the input voltage, here they require the DC source. And another important thing, this is about the difference about your amplifier and oscillator. And lastly, finally, another as we have studied in the basic about the rectifier. As we know the rectifier will convert AC to DC, but oscillator will convert DC to AC. That also one difference about oscillator and your rectifier. As we all studied already in the basic about in first year about rectifiers, the rectifier will convert AC to DC, but oscillator convert DC to DC. This is the major difference about oscillator and rectifier. And now we go for the what are the types of oscillator. We go for the types of oscillator. We'll go for the types of oscillator. We go for the types of oscillator. Look here, there are so many types of oscillators. Basically, the first one is about depends on the waveform. Depends on the waveform. The output waveform, not on the one is called sinusoidal. One is called your sinusoidal. The oscillator will give you the output that is always in terms of sinusoidal. It means in oscillator, if the output of the oscillator is only sinusoidal, that type of oscillator is called sinusoidal oscillator. It is a type of oscillator. In this oscillator, output is always sine wave. Output always sine wave. That type of oscillator is nothing but sinusoidal oscillator. The sinusoidal oscillator, it is a type of oscillator. In this oscillator, always output is in terms of sinusoidal or in terms of sine wave. And similarly, the non-sinusoidal, here it is also a type of oscillator. In this oscillator, output is other than sinusoidal. It may be square wave, it may be triangular wave, it may be sawtooth, and that type of oscillator is called non-sinusoidal. In simple way, in sinusoidal, the output is only sine wave. But in non-sinusoidal, the output is other than sine wave. It may be a square wave, it may be a triangular wave, it may be a sawtooth wave, like that. And especially, you are studying in detail about this sinusoidal oscillator. I am the syllabus to study about the, in detail about the sinusoidal oscillators. It means, depending upon the waveform, you have done two types of oscillators, sinusoidal, non-sinusoidal. Sinusoidal nothing but the output is only sine wave. The oscillator having the output only sine wave. That type of oscillator nothing but the sinusoidal oscillators. But in non-sinusoidal, in non-sinusoidal side oscillator, it is a type of oscillator. In this oscillator, the output is other than sine wave. It may be your square wave, it may be triangular wave, it may be sawtooth wave. This also you have done the types depending on the waveform, the sinusoidal and non-sinusoidal. And now we go for another type of oscillator that depends upon the frequency. One is called audio frequency oscillator. And second one is about the radio frequency oscillator. It means they are very simple. This type of oscillator, they will produce only the audio frequency. The range of the frequency or your constant oscillator that will produce the frequency range in terms of audio frequency. You know what audio frequency? 22 hertz. The depending on frequency, you have done the two types of oscillator, audio frequency oscillator. The oscillator, they will generate the frequency in the range of 22 to 20 kilohertz. and or you can say low frequency oscillator. It is a type of low frequency oscillator. And in RF oscillator, you are especially you are using communication about high frequency signals. They are using RF oscillators. RF oscillator nothing but it is a type of oscillator. They are generated the very high frequency, that is more than 20 kilowatts or more than megahertz. This is depends upon the frequency what are the types of oscillators, that is EF nothing but audio frequency, RF nothing but radio frequency oscillators. And another book are depending upon the feedback components. Depending upon the feedback components. Feedback components. You have done the three types of oscillators. One is called LC oscillators. LC oscillator. And another is called RC oscillator. And finally it is called crystal oscillator. It means depending on the feedback components, you have done the three types of oscillator. You are studying in detail about these all three types of oscillators. LC nothing but while constructing the oscillators, you are using L and C components. The oscillator is constructed by using L and C components. It means in as I said, in oscillator we are using positive feedback. In the oscillator we are using the positive feedback, and that feedback network or feedback circuit that consists of L and C. The feedback network that consists of L and C, that type of oscillator nothing but LC oscillators. Or I can say the oscillator is constructed by using L and C, and it is used for the high frequency generation. The LC oscillator are used for the to generate the high frequency signals. And RC oscillator, nothing but same, this is the type of oscillator. In this oscillator, in the feedback you are using R and C combination, or you are using R and C components. While constructing the oscillator, in the feedback you are using R and C. That's what is called as RC oscillator. It is used for the low frequency generation. It is used for the low frequency generation. It is used for the high frequency generation. And finally, you are using crystal oscillator. It is so important oscillator because it will generate high frequency. Also, it is generate. It is having the most stability in the frequency. It is having the most stable in the frequency. And it means in the feedback, you are using a crystal. In the feedback, you are using in the feedback, not you are using the crystal. It means in place of LC, you are using the crystal. And that type of oscillator only called crystal oscillator. Very simple. Depending upon the feedback components, you have done the three types of oscillator: LC oscillator, RC oscillator, and crystal oscillator. In your LC oscillator, the oscillator constructed by using L and C in the feedback network, and it is used for the high frequency generation. And in the same way, the RC oscillator, it is a type of oscillator. In this oscillator, in the feedback we are using R and C components, and it is used for the low frequency generation. And finally, you are going for the crystal oscillator. It is very good oscillator because having the most frequency stability. The frequency is constant. That's why you prefer crystal oscillator. We will go in detail afterwards. Crystal oscillator, it is also a type of oscillator. Here you are using in the feedback bar, you are using crystal. This about you are done the types of oscillator depending upon the feedback. And as I said already, actually you are studying in this topic nearly about the sinusoidal oscillators. You are studying about the sinusoidal oscillator. You are studying about the sinusoidal oscillator. That means you are studying about the sinusoidal oscillator. Look here in your sinus oscillator, you are studying once again the two types in sinusoidal. You are studying the two types of oscillators. One is called damped oscillator. And the second one is called undamped oscillator. Look here, they will ask one more question. What are damped oscillations? Oscillator and what are undamped oscillators? It means very simple. In your sinusoidal oscillators, once again you have done the small types, that is damped oscillation and undamped oscillation. Always we prefer the undamped oscillation. Always we prefer the undamped oscillation. Or we have another name of undamped is nothing but we want the sustained oscillation. We want the sustained oscillations. And we'll go for that in your what is called damped oscillator, or what is called damped oscillation. The oscillator, for example, you can write here the diagram, then you can understand very easily about the here. The important thing is about what is called damped oscillator. It is a type of oscillator, or it is a type of penetrator oscillation. In this oscillation, the amplitude of the signal will decreases with respect to time. Once again, repeat. In damped oscillations, or the damped oscillator, it is a type of oscillator, or it is a type of electric oscillation. In this, the amplitude of the signal will be decreases with respect to time. The amplitude or magnitude of signal will be decreases with respect to time, or can say the amplitude or magnitude is not constant. The damped oscillation, it is a type of oscillation, or it is a type of electrical oscillation. In this, the output signal, the amplitude of the output signal will be decreases with respect to time. Is that correct? In your damped oscillations or damped oscillator, nothing but it is a type of oscillator. In this oscillator, the output signal or the amplitude of the output signal will be decreases with respect to time. In damped oscillator, the amplitude of the signal will be decreases with respect to time. That type of oscillator nothing but damped oscillator. Damped oscillator, it is a type of oscillator. In this oscillator, the amplitude of the signal or amplitude of the output signal will be decreases with respect to time. That type of oscillator nothing but damped oscillator. In damped oscillator, the amplitude or magnitude of the signal or magnitude of the output voltage will be decreases with respect to time. That is nothing but damped oscillator. And another one is about undamped oscillator. Undamped oscillator. Undamped nothing but, it's very simple. Here we are having the precision type of oscillator. In this oscillator, the amplitude of the signal will be constant with respect to time. It means amplitude is not decreasing. The amplitude of the signal is constant with respect to time. That is nothing but undamped oscillation. We want like that oscillations. It is also called as sustained oscillation. Followed, undamped nothing but the magnitude or amplitude of signal is not changing with respect to time. It is constant with respect to time. The amplitude or the magnitude of the signal, output signal or voltage will be constant with respect to time. It is not decreasing, it is constant with respect to time. That is nothing but
undamped oscillation. That is nothing but undamped oscillations. This is about the two types of sinusoidal oscillators. One is called damped oscillator, another is called undamped oscillator, or you can say oscillations, damped or undamped oscillations, oscillations or oscillator, right? The oscillator will give the oscillations or they will give the AC signals. And coming up on the another so important, that is about what is the principle behind the oscillator. We go for the principle, the basic principle. We go for the basic principle. Principle of the oscillator. The basic principle of your oscillator. As I said already, I said in the time of beginning, the oscillator, it is a circuit or device, they require the positive feedback. And you have studied in detail about in feedback amplifiers. The most important application of feedback that is used in amplifiers. The most important application of positive feedback, they are used in your oscillators. It means in your oscillator, you are using a positive feedback. As I said, the oscillator, it is a type of amplifier. The important thing, you are using a positive feedback. Oscillator, it is also a type of amplifier. Only that difference is about you are using positive feedback. Because as I said already, the amplifier will also convert AC. The DC to AC, but oscillator also convert DC to AC. But thing is that the amplifier, they require the negative feedback, oscillator require the positive feedback. Amplifier, they require the input voltage, but oscillator, they does not require the input. That is a major difference about oscillator and amplifier. And as we know already, what is positive feedback? The positive feedback nothing but the feedback voltage and input voltage are in the in phase, or you can say the feedback voltage will increases the input voltage. That type of feedback can be called the positive feedback. And you can move for the log diagram of feedback. This is the principle of our feedback. You are using a basic amplifier. Basic amplifier. Having a gain E and it is having a feedback network. It is having a feedback network that is beta. And here we have a separator. Here I am the output voltage. And here you can connect a feedback that is V naught, and here is called separator, and here we are using a mixer. The input side is a mixer. And as I said,
oscillator, it is a type of amplifier. But thing is, you are using positive feedback. And what is positive feedback? Positive feedback is nothing but the input or output are in the same phase. The input or output are in the same phase. That is nothing but your positive feedback. And you are done already in the time of feedback amplifiers. What is the voltage gain for the negative feedback amplifier? Now you have to find out the voltage gain for the positive feedback amplifier. I'll write about voltage gain. And as we saw, we know the gain, the open loop gain, we know that the open loop gain, that is open loop gain, that is gain is equal to V naught by V. This is equation number one. And this has been the closed loop gain. Gain without feedback. The closed loop gain with feedback. That is EF. The gain with feedback is nothing but V naught by Vs. This is equation number. And as usual, you know the beta. Yes, what is beta? The feedback factor. That is nothing but yes, Vf by V0. Or you can write here, we want Vf. Vf equal to beta into V0. And because you are considering the positive feedback, that's what happens. You are considering the positive feedback. The input and this is maybe your output T and V naught. This is T and V naught. It means here for positive feedback, it is said already in positive feedback, what happens? Voltage nothing but Vs plus Vf. As we have negative feedback, the input voltage is nothing but Vs minus Vf. Because as I said, in negative feedback, the feedback signal, input signal, they are out of phase. And also, in negative feedback, the feedback signal reduces the input voltage. But now we are going for positive feedback. The positive feedback nothing but the feedback signal and input signal, they are in the same phase, and positive feedback will add the input voltage. Or you can say the positive feedback will increase the input voltage. That's why I am using plus. The positive feedback will increase the input voltage. That's why I am using plus here. And we can substitute the Vf here by using beta and V0. We may get Vi. Vs as it is. Vs as it is. And in place of Vf, we can write beta and V0. We can write beta into V0. Now, as it is, we can write Vi. Or you can take V. Beta V0 is this way. Vs equal to Vi minus beta into V. Theta. This may be equation number 3. This is nothing but only the subject Vf. Vf nothing but beta into V0. And now you subject the Vs in equation number 2. Put the equation 3 in equation 2, that becomes AF. AF equal to S V naught as it is. Now in place of this Vs, you can write Vi minus beta into A naught. You can write Vi minus beta into V naught. Right up. Now the divide numerator denominator by Vi. Divide Vi on numerator and denominator. That becomes EF equal to V naught by Vi divided by Vi by Vi minus beta as it is V naught by Vi. You simplify it, as you know, V naught by Vi is nothing but E, and here Vi will cancel. We may get AF equal to EF equal to S A divided by 1 minus A B. You see the final the feedback which is given. This is nothing but the simple principle behind the oscillator, or actually as I said, the voltage gain for the positive feedback. But on same steps in the time of negative feedback, voltage gain. Only thing is that you are considering the negative feedback, now you are considering positive feedback. That's why cannot Vi is equal to Vs plus Vf. Remaining we know the voltage, we know with the open loop gain, we know closed loop gain, or without feedback, with feedback, we know the feedback factor. Here important thing, the A nothing but open loop gain or the gain without feedback, and here beta nothing but feedback factor, and here nothing but the gain with feedback. The gain with feedback. This is about in simple way of the expression. It means here the important thing about why we get what is the condition of stability of the sustained oscillation. What is the condition of stability, or what is the condition of sustained oscillations? And for that, maybe you follow this, is very simple, and you can consider here. It is very simple. As I said already, this, you know, the voltage, the gain without feedback, gain with feedback, and you know the feedback factor. And this is V1, Vf, that is beta V0, and for positive feedback, as I said, Vi, Vs plus Vf. Here you have done the Vf value, beta into V0, and you will take the Vs, beta V on this side, and you Vs will take this side. We may get Vs is equal to Vi minus beta into V0, and here you consider the equation, this equation 2. This equation you can substitute Vs value. We may get Vi minus beta V naught. Then you can divide numerator and denominator by Vi. You can divide Vi on numerator and denominator. Then we may get V naught by Vi, Vi by Vi, and beta constant outside, V naught by Vi, V naught by Vi nothing but A, Vi by Vi 1, and beta is V naught by Vi nothing but A beta. This is in simple way of your explanation. And finally, go for what is the condition of stability, or in which condition we get the sustained oscillations. What is the stability of oscillator? Look here, consider the voltage gain for the positive feedback, that is A divided by 1 minus AB. E divided by 1 minus AB. The important thing here, as I said already, EF nothing but the gain with feedback, A nothing but without feedback, and theta nothing but feedback factor. Here the important thing, if you want the stability of the oscillator, if you want the sustained oscillation, what you have to do? The condition is that the A beta equal to the equation of Hartree. Put A beta equal to 1 in equation 1. That becomes EF equal to E divided by 1 minus 1. That is nothing but E divided by 0. And E divided by 0 nothing but E by 0 nothing but E infinity. It means here, as we know already, gain always the EF generate V naught by ES. Actually, here the V naught by 0. It means here the A beta you consider as 1. If you consider A beta as 1, that then denominator becomes a 0. It means A divided by 1 minus 1 0. A by 0, nothing by 0, nothing but infinity. It means in your oscillator, if the gain is infinity, means it's nothing but you are not applying any input. If without applying input, you get the output. That is nothing but the A by 0, nothing but infinity. It means if you take the condition A beta equal to 1, in that time what happens, will get the output infinity. It means you are getting the output voltage without applying an input. You will get the if the output infinity means you will get the output without applying an input. Because as I said, the Vs is 0. Vs 0 nothing but without applying any input, it will give the output, and that is nothing but your oscillator. What is oscillator? The oscillator is a device or circuit. In oscillator, without applying any input, but still it will give the output, that is nothing but oscillator. It means according to the mathematically approved, in oscillator you are not applying any input, still you will get the output. How means? You take the condition of A beta equal to 1. A beta equal to 1 nothing but you can take A beta nothing but loop gain. You asserted already in the feedback amplifiers, A beta nothing but loop gain. Whenever the loop gain is 1, in that time what happens? In that time we will get the output, that is without input. If you consider it in this equation, A beta equal to 1 means you are having A divided by 1 minus 1 0. Anything by 0 nothing but infinity. It means you have get the output without input. Because we know in oscillator you are not applying any input, still you will get the output. That is the condition of your oscillator. What is the condition oscillator? Or what is the condition of sustained oscillator? Or what is the condition of stability oscillator? That is important thing. The A beta equal to 1. Whenever the A beta equal to 1, in that time we will get the output, that is without the input. Because you know P not the Vs, the Vs is 0. Vs 0 nothing but you are not applying any input, but still you will get the output. It means in oscillator, nothing but it is a circuit or device, in oscillator we are not applying any input, still you will get the output, that is from this equation. Because as you know about the feedback amplifier, the voltage gain, that is A divided by 1 minus A beta. But here you take the condition, the condition, put A beta equal to 1 in this equation, that then A divided by 1 minus 1, that is A by 0. A by 0, anything by 0, nothing but infinity. Infinity nothing but you will get the output, that is without input. Because V naught by Vs. V naught nothing but output, Vs nothing but input. In this equation, the Vs is 0. It means you are not applying any input, still you will get the output, that is nothing but your oscillator. And this is the basic principle behind oscillator, because as I said, in oscillator you are using the positive feedback, and also if you want the sustained oscillation, if we want the stability in the oscillation, then we want the condition oscillator, that is nothing but A beta equal to 1. This is condition so important. If you support the A beta equal to in this equation, we may get the output, that is without input. This is about the principle of oscillator, and in the next class we go for the remaining things. Thank you.